to Fab Finds by Keetra. So if this is your first time on my channel, welcome to Fab Finds. And if you are returning to my channel, hey boo, hey Bougieville boos, welcome back. You already know the drill and the routine. Go ahead and grab your mocktails, honey. Grab your cocktails and get you a nice tropical snack. Because today on the Bougieville train, we're getting ready to take off, but we're going somewhere tropical. So I'll go ahead and let you get settled. In the meantime, let me go ahead and welcome the new booze aboard the Bougieville train. So hey, new booze, yes honey, I am talking about you. If this is your first time on my channel, guess what? Over here at Fab Finds by Keetra, we talk about all things fabulous when it comes to a good fragrance, okay? I'm just saying, we love fragrances over here. And it can be anything from designer, it can be niche, honey, it can be luxury. If it's fabulous and I go out and I fall in love with it, I'm gonna bring it back here and I'm going to share it with you guys. So if that's something that you wanna be a part of, then you definitely wanna consider clicking on that subscribe button and hopping on this train to Bougieville, honey, because we're going somewhere fabulous. Every Sunday, we're gonna go somewhere fabulous. Another thing that we do over here at Fab Finds by Keetra, honey, it is all about positive energy. Yes, yes, okay. Positive energy, positive vibes. And if you don't mind me addressing you as hey boo, hey gorgeous, then this is definitely the place for you. So without further ado, let's hop aboard this Bougieville train and let's go somewhere fabulous. Boo, we are here. And you're like, where are we? Honey, your girl took you on a tropical vacation, and guess what? You didn't need your passport, and you didn't need to pack a bag. No, ma'am. Mm-mm. Because the fragrance that I am bringing to you guys today, it is definitely going to be a vacation, a tropical vacation in a bottle. When I tell you that Kay Ollie Fragrances has been bringing the heat for me this season, honey, let me tell you, Mona came out on fire. At first, your girl hit us with this sweet diamond pink pepper, honey, sexy date night fragrance. And then she had the nerve to take me somewhere tropical. And she knew that I was wanting to go somewhere. She knew that I wanted my toes in the sand. She knew I wanted to be laid out on the beach listening to the ocean waves. Like, she knew I needed all of that. And that's exactly what she brought me, okay? And now I am going to bring it to you. And I am talking about none other than... yes, girl. Utopia Vanilla Coco 21. Yes. Let me tell you, this fragrance right here, it is truly a vacation in a bottle. Real quick, I'm going to get into the packaging with you guys. Let me tell you, like any other of the Kay Ollie fragrances, it's going to come in this box. But for me, this box is a little special, honey, because there's like a little shimmer sheen on the outside. And you know we love being extra, honey. Any little extra detail that's going to stick out, I am like, sign me up. I want it. Send it to me, okay? I'm just saying. So, of course, you're going to get this beautiful, soft rose gold on the outside of the box. And, of course, with all Kay Ollie fragrances, they list the notes on the back. And that is a big thing, especially for fragrance lovers who get into reading notes, trying to see if the fragrance is compared to something, or trying to see if the notes that the fragrance is made of is going to be something that they are looking for, or are there notes that they already love and fragrances that are in their collection that have the similar notes to it. So that is the good thing about that. Now, of course, like I said, you're going to get the signature Kay Ollie on the front. There is the diamond that is right here. Now, I will tell you, this is another EDP Intense fragrance by Kay Ollie, and this is their second one. Of course, like I said, the first one was the Sweet Diamond Pink Pepper, and this is the second Intense version in this fragrance line by Kay Ollie. So, okay, of course, you're going to raise that top off, honey, like that, okay? And here that diamond is. Darling, you already know, honey, your girl is over here collecting diamonds, okay? Liz Taylor, who? Where's she at? Because I got my own diamonds. They're Kay Ollie diamonds, but I have them. Of course, that is, for me, that's just a vibe within itself, because I am such a girly girl. And this diamond sitting on top of this bottle, hello, everything. Everything. So of course you are going to pull out your fragrance out of the box, and here she is. When I tell you this fragrance reminds me of some type of like rose gold goddess or something. Yes, girl, I am the princess on the beach. or the queen. I'll take the queen. But I love it. I love the color. And then it also has like this little blue tint to it. It's almost as if, girl, Tropical Nights. That's exactly what it is. Tropical Nights out there on the beach, honey, wearing my Utopia Vanilla Coco 21. And you already know what that 21 means, honey. That turns your mocktail into a cocktail. Okay? I'm just saying. So of course, here are the fragrances, guys. Let me tell you, it was love at first sniff for me. It was love at first spray. I could not wait to get this fragrance because I thought to myself, I have to have it. It just seems like this is something that I have been looking for because I did not get to go on my vacation this year. And so I was wanting my toes in the sand and I needed something to take me there. And this fragrance definitely did it for me. So of course, in this fragrance, guys, you are going to get notes of, and I will tell you, it is a warm floral fragrance, okay? It has honeysuckle in it. And the one thing that I love about that honeysuckle, it definitely took me back to a fun memory of me growing up, honey, in the country, and me and my cousins would go outside and we would pull those honeysuckles off the tree and we would suck that little juice out of that flower. And it was just so refreshing. Yes. Did you guys do that? Were you like out there sucking on those honeysuckles? I know we probably should have been doing that, but girl, that was just what you did, honey. We were in the country. So another note that is in here, of course, is the pear blossom, Italian lemon. There is coconut in its fragrance, jasmine, gardenia, tuberose, amaretto, sandalwood, patchouli, vanilla bourbon, and musk. Absolutely gorgeous, okay? It is a warm white floral fragrance. It is very sweet. It is very creamy. It's very milky. It's a milky soft coconut fragrance, if you ask me, okay? Now, they say that it's intense, but I will tell you, and I will get to that. For me, I don't know if I got intense out of this fragrance. It very much so sits close to my skin is what it does. It's calm, it's relaxing, and I can see myself just sitting out there on the beach with my toes in the sand as the sun is going down, just catching a little whiff of myself as the wind is blowing, okay? It definitely coats your skin, it sits close to your skin, and it's very soft. Now, with that being said, I do have to overspray this fragrance, okay? I do have to overspray it, and I don't know if I'm just overspraying it because I love the way it smells, or I'm overspraying it because I'm wanting more. I'm wanting more of the fragrance. I will tell you what I have been doing is I tried to the fragrance at first just on its own, and I got about 4 hours out of it, okay? But it was very, like I said, it was very close to my skin. It was very soft, and you definitely had to come close. It's gonna be an intimate vacation in a bottle, okay? You are not gonna, I did not get beast mode projection in your face out there. I didn't get that. For my skin and my body chemistry, I did not get that. But what I got was a very beautiful, gorgeous fragrance that just coated my skin and laid on my skin like a soft veil, honey. And it just sat there. And as I moved my arm and as I moved my, just any movement, I would catch a little soft whiff of it. And okay, that's so what I was
to start spraying this bottle.
If you did not know, Kay Ollie, let me tell you, the item is absolutely bomb.com, honey. When you spray this fragrance, it is a very luxurious, honey. The way this fragrance comes out of this bottle, girl, just look. Oh my gosh. Look at that. Oh my gosh. Oh my gosh. Oh, girl. Whew, honey. Tropical vacation. Here I am. It smells so gorgeous. Oh my God, it smells like soft, creamy, rich, decadent coconut. Yes, girl, creamy, soft, milky, definitely vacation in a bottle.
So what okay. I will tell you guys with this fragrance, what I tried and what I started doing throughout the week so that I can kind of really get a really good feel for it was that I started layering the fragrance, okay?
Now, let me tell you, ladies, if you are wanting your fragrance to
project a little bit more, last a little bit longer. Make sure that you are not adding your fragrance already to dry skin, especially a fragrance that has alcohol in it already. Because if your skin is dry, that affects the performance of your fragrance. And believe it or not, your pH balance, like everything goes into when you are spraying your fragrance, it could be a factor as to how that fragrance will perform on you. I have worn a fragrance that, let me tell you, that I have received so many compliments off of. Some people have purchased a fragrance. Some coworkers have picked up the very same fragrance. And I even had one coworker to bring me the fragrance, bring it to me and give it to me because she was like, it just doesn't smell like it smells on you. I'm not getting that. So this is just your fragrance. And she gave it to me because it wasn't performing for her. Because guess what? We have different body chemistries. Now, what I will tell you, if you are looking for your fragrance to last and to linger a little bit longer, to give you a little bit more sillage, to give you a little bit more longevity when you're wearing it, try prepping your skin to receive that fragrance. And moisturized skin will definitely let that fragrance soak into your body. Now, I picked up this Fenty Skin body butter, okay? And when, girls, guys, let me tell you, when I tell you it is absolutely amazing, it is amazing. And what I like most about this body butter is that it is very lightly scented, okay? So there's not a lot of fragrance with it. It's just a slight fragrance with it. And it's not so overbearing as to where it will take over your fragrance and give it a whole nother scent. No, it doesn't do that. But I will layer this body butter with any of the fragrances that I have in my collection because, like I said, it's a good universal body butter to do that. Now, that was something, this is something that I was layering my skin with the Fenty Skin and the vanilla, the Utopia Vanilla Coco 21. And so I just took a little bit of it and I basically just rubbed it wherever. Girl, look at that. Oh my goodness. Oh yes, child. Honey. Girl, and what I love the most about this body butter, honey, it is thick, it is rich, and it is creamy, and it's perfect for this Utopia Vanilla Coco 21. Girl, and that's all I did, and I just sprayed it on there. And so I got a little bit more longevity out of the fragrance just by simply layering it with a body cream. Another thing that I've been also doing with this fragrance, with the Utopia Vanilla Coco 21, is I also layered it with another fragrance that it kind of puts me in the mind of. Now, I am not saying that this is this fragrance because I get two totally different vibes with it, but I also layered it this week with my Tom Ford Soleil Blanc in the Shimmering Body Oil. Now, with this right here, the Shimmering Body Oil by Tom Ford, it just kind of gives you a nice little shimmer and a nice little glow. So I would put it on just like that. I would rub it in. And what I love about that is that it gives it like a little glow to your skin because of the sparkles that's in it. So it just kind of takes that Utopia up to the next level. And then of course I would take my fragrance and I would layer and spray it on top of that as well. And so that way I kind of got, oh my goodness. Oh my God, that smells so good. Oh my God. So if you have the Tom Ford Soleil Blanc in your collection, whether it's in the body oil or if you have it in the body fragrance. Now I know also there is a spray body oil that comes in like a little white canister, kind of like the body sprays. Try that with the Utopia Vanilla Coco because, oh my God, it smells amazing. Now, another fragrance, and you know, honey, I could not have a Kay Ali fragrance in my collection and not layer her with my number one absolute favorite fragrance ever in the Kay Ali collection, and that is my Vanilla 28, honey. So when you mix the Utopia Vanilla Coco with this right here, the Vanilla 28 by Kay Ali. Girl, when I tell you it would change your whole entire life. And so what I would do is I will layer, of course, the Vanilla 28. And then I will go through, honey, and do a nice little layer just like that with the, oh my gosh. This right here and this right here together. get your tropical life. Oh my God. So another thing, if you have another fragrance that is in your collection that has some of the similar notes, so you wanna kinda keep it within the same family. So if there's a fragrance with a little bit of vanilla, or if you have a fragrance that kinda gives you that little tropical vibe, try mixing it with the Utopia Vanilla Cocoa 21 and see if you can get a little bit more to your fragrance. Now I will tell you, when I did layer these two right here, girl, when I tell you, I did have a scent bubble, because there's something in this Vanilla 28, honey, that is the perfect blend that will basically, you can mix this with anything, honey. You can mix Vanilla 28 with absolutely anything and it will take it to the next level. And it's exactly what I did with this right here, honey. Utopia Vanilla Cocoa 21 and Vanilla 28. This combination right here will get you in your hot girl tropical vibes for sure. Okay? I'm just saying, I have been rocking it all week long. I have been testing it and trying it out. And let me tell you, for me, it is definitely a fab find. So guys, that is it. That is it, and I hope you have enjoyed Fab Finds by Keetra. So until our next fabulous Fab Find, ooh, smooches.